Hey, it's That City Show with your host, Eric Crossland. Pleasure to collaborate on news. Today's guest is Joel Jimenez. I'm your announcer, Benjamin Remmert. And now, he wishes the show Fixer Upper would visit his home, Eric Crossland.
Wait, that's before they move into the house. How dare you? You never stay at my place again. Hi, welcome to That City Show. What city?
Wichita Falls.
And it's done now. Fixer Upper's gone.
No sad problem. Day. Yeah, you know, yeah. We don't start projects anymore. We started like putting in like trim, like I don't know, 4 years ago when we moved in. It's still not done.
Yeah, I've been working on my water main for 6 months. Hey, City Show. Let's go ahead and get in our 3 second pose. Let everybody know who we are. We always like to theme it after our guest, Joel Jimenez is here, and he's here to talk about the DAV. So let's do a patriotic pose today, huh?
All right.
These veterans out here, you ready?
Let's do it. I'm ready.
All right, I'm going to take the easy one. My name is Eric Crossland. I'm your public information officer. And thanks for your service, sir.
So much wrong with that salute.
Did I do it wrong?
You did. So
how was that?
I'm also going to... So when I was in the military, we used to send the planes out. The last thing you do is you salute the pilot on their way out. Ah. So that's what I'm going to do. So my name is Benjamin Rimmer. I'm your social media marketing specialist. Pass them off. Salute. And then they're gone.
Ooh, which one do you want me to freeze that on?
This one right here.
Okay.
That one's legit.
All right. Can I read your mind just for the
feel like this.
Oh, okay. All right. Golly.
I'm a military.
Jenna, see if you can do it without insulting.
I will try. Hi, I'm Jenna Lambert, Exhibits Curator at the Riverbend Nature Center, and this is my military pose.
All right, there we go.
It's a power pose. I like
angry.
It.
Angry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, is it?
Okay. Such a war face.
I don't know. That is my war face.
All right,
it's
guys.
My mom face.
Let's go ahead and get right on into some city biz. Are you ready?
Let's do
it. City biz for you and me and everyone. City biz, we'll try to make it somewhat fun.
Mediocre.
Take two on everything today. Ben, what'd that city biz do?
City biz, hey, animal services. Who doesn't like animals and dogs? We go there, we do a video every Wednesday on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh, hate them. But Animal Services, they have lots of adoption events throughout the year. They're doing one on Cinco de Mayo, which is on Saturday, May 5th. And that will be from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. So this one's a little bit different because it's not, hey, just come out to Animal Services. There's going to be multiple animal organizations involved in this event, as well as food trucks. Some of the organizations are going to be Pets, Texas Pit Crew, Wild Bird Rescue, and like four other ones that I don't know names off the top of my head. So get there, check it out. All these groups work together as a team, a forward community, just gonna be at Animal Services.
Ooh, Cinco de Mayo, only celebrated in America.
Yep, and that's my birthday. I'll also be celebrating Cinco de Mayo after Animal Services.
How old will be turning, Ben?
80.
30.
Welcome to the dark side.
I'm going to a positive.
That's when your life's over, you know? It just goes downhill 30, from there. Yeah.
Wow.
If you're
that's
female.
That's really negative. Anyway, I'm going Hey, Circle Trail Tour. If you haven't heard about this yet, go on Facebook, look up Circle Trail Tour. There's an event there. The Wichita Falls Step Committee is inviting.
Don't tell our viewers what to do, okay?
Or, you know, you don't have to do it. But, hey, you're invited. The Wichita Falls Step Committee has invited you to the Circle Trail Tour on Saturday, April 28th, and that's from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. It starts in Lucy Park. You pick up your passport. It goes on 14 miles and finishes at Lake Wichita Park. Every mile, there's a stamp that you get on your passport. There'll be prizes, refreshments, all along the way.
Stamps.
And if you make it, if you get all your stamps, then you get entered in to win the grand prize, which we still don't know what that is yet.
I hear it's a yacht.
That'd be
yacht
great.
For Lake Wichita.
It's definitely a good investment.
If there's no wind. So definitely check that out. You can run it, walk it, bike it, bring your dog, bring your kids. Hopefully the weather's nice out there. Just a free event for you to come and enjoy the trail system.
Yeah,
that'd be really hard.
Get you some vitamin D, get you out in the sun.
Wear protection on your
skin. If you don't like milk, get your vitamin D.
Yeah.
Sun.
I don't know, saying get protection right after again.
That's, you don't get that.
Okay, Jenica.
Was that city biz, man?
What?
Is that it?
Yeah, that's
it. All right. That was city biz for you and me and everyone. City biz, Ben just made it somewhat fun.
A little bit awkward.
Yeah, as always, he tore his papers, now it's a drink.
You're going to pay for my eye surgery. Guns.
Yeah, we're going to get you a pair of goggles.
Yeah, I'm going to. I need some. I need a guard between us.
You should know it's dangerous. Coming by now, though, in Matrix.
Yeah, yeah.
What is this?
Yeah.
Yeah, seems like a solution. I'd rather just complain.
You talking about the salute I did earlier? All right, so to set me straight on my salute and all that stuff, coming up after the break, ooh, one of our favorites. I'll apologize in advance. This guy's kind of low energy.
Yeah. I know. So dull.
Probably a little dull. It's going to get a little dull over here. Talking to us all about the DAV and veterans benefits and why, if you're a veteran, you should be using them. I need him to talk to you specifically. Joel Jimenez, when we come back after this break.
Did you know nearly 1.1 million people are living in the U.S. with HIV? One in five don't even know they're infected. The Wichita Falls, Wichita County Public Health District provides free HIV tests. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommend that all adults be tested for HIV. Being tested for HIV is quick, easy, and free. The first step in fighting HIV is to take the test. Call 761-7841 for your free HIV test. That's 761-7841.
Between me and my two friends, I'm the one that has to ride with the snorkel because I'm swimming in a cloud of smoke.
Buckle up, stay safe.
Seatbelt save, but secondhand smoke kills.
Proper name, Jenica Lambert right there.
Jenica proper.
Jenica proper. Curator at Riverbend Nature Center. That there's Benjamin Rimmert. He's a social media marketing for the city. About to turn 30. Ooh.
Ooh. Man.
Ooh. And then I'm Eric Crossland. I'm your public information officer. And now, joining us, representing the DAV, one Joel Jimenez. How you doing, Joel?
Yep.
That's it. Yeah, that's how we do it.
Good morning, Vietnam.
Okay.
I'll tell you what. Hey. There's so much excitement.
Oh, hey, Joel.
It's Joel.
What is your name?
Joel.
Your title on your 3-second pose of that camera right
there. Jimenez, chapter 41 in Wichita Falls, Texas. Well, how about the salute?
Perfect. Hey, that way.
The pose.
Cool.
All right, Joel.
Amen.
You are here. You're representing the DAV.
Let me tell you.
Tell us what it
Let
is.
Let me tell you something. Did you ever hear that that little slogan? Where's the beef?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to tell everybody, this right here is for every family, every veteran in North Texas that can hear my voice, and I'm going to say, where's your discharge paper?
Oh.
It's very serious here, Jenica, because let me tell you why. Veterans call me all the time, and they say, my dad just passed away, and I need a flag. And the first thing the service officer, any organization is going to ask them, where's your discharge paper? That's the identity of the veteran. You got to have that. And many of them did not file it when they got out of the service like they were supposed to. Mm. Of course, I was Army and Navy people, you know. Anyway, but that's very important right now. That's the most important thing to get these benefits and medical attention or anything from the ferocious VA. We are advocates for and against the VA, and that's the first thing they're going to ask you. Where's your discharge paper? Because we can see what we can do for you. And that opens a lot of doors. Where's your discharge paper at, Ben?
My glove box, my car.
That's safe. Most veterans, we're going to have to check on that.
I have a lot of copies of it, though.
Well, let me tell you something about right now on the 50th year anniversary of the Vietnam War, which happened between 1955 and 1976. If you ask that era of veteran, like myself, say, where's your discharge paper? And he says, at home. Okay, that's great. many, many calls we get from the service officers and they, and the wife, the widow, the uncle, the aunt, the daughter, the son comes up and says, we can't find it. Now, there are some websites that you can go get your discharge paper, but it's going to take about 10 days to 3 weeks. But the let's say the veteran has to be buried in 3 days.
Yeah.
With honors that he or she so deserved. Oh, let me add this. In my time, it was all men. This day and time, Ben's day and time, women.
I've heard
women
that.
Are now in the combat situation that they deserve so much.
Yeah. Yes.
And this is very important. Where's your discharge paper?
Mm. So get your discharge papers.
Yes. Thank you so much. Because that opens a lot of doors. If you go up there to that office and say, hey, look, I got ill, shot, wounded, burnt, whatever. I need special attention. I need medical attention. Remember, there's two sides of VA. VA disability and VA medical.
Yeah.
And we stress that all veterans get into the system, the VA system. Now, remember this. There's about 300 and something claims backlog. But right now, these organizations, these service organizations, are stepping up to the VA system and making it, I say, quicker. But you've been in the military, Ben. You know, you remember that hurry up and wait in line?
Oh, yeah.
Same thing. So keep your patience. I'm talking to all my
veterans.
That's
why I haven't gone in.
I know. You see, that's a good testimony. We're afraid, some veterans, and now it's affecting the veteran. Oh, let me tell you another thing. You're going to be full of information today. I'm going to get your curiosity.
We're usually full of something.
Back in that era of time, the Vietnam era, the Vietnam War, there was a lot of us that got in trouble and got Article 15s. So now, Ben, did you know you can clean up your discharge paper now?
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah, you get this. You go down to the annex, get a form, and just because you got caught drinking, let's say.
I can see that.
Just a little drinking.
Yeah.
Well, in your time, Ben, you're out of here. They don't want that.
You get two times. I know.
Okay, you see. Well, I'm glad he said that. I didn't know that two times. In our time, get out of here.
Wow.
Yeah.
Man.
And a man goes, his grandmother dies. I've had seven veterans come to me. My grandma, why did you get an Article 15? I went AWOL. AWOL is a bad word.
Yeah.
But
he went to a funeral.
Isn't that something?
Yeah.
How come you caught on to it?
I don't know.
All right. In the military, get out of here, you're out. Okay. That's one thing. Now you can go down there and clean up your discharge paper. And it's just like a review board. They say, well, I jumped the fence and I went to see my grandmother's funeral and I came back. 7 days later, get out of here.
Wow.
And it shouldn't be that way.
Hey, Joel, what are some of the other things that veterans might not know that they're missing out on by not filing their papers and all that?
Medical.
On the medical part, it's so.
I think a lot of it, veterans probably don't even. Maybe it's been a long time since you've been in. They might not even know what their benefits are at all. Or like
they don't.
What gets covered or what doesn't cover. So, you know, for me, if it's hearing, I don't really care about it now. I am going through that. I don't care about it now. But I know that when I'm older, I could probably get a lot of my things covered.
There's no profit. Don't say that word. There's no profit. There is, because you served honorably. And let's say the way we prove that you've got a problem on here, and let's say, what was your MOS? Or in the Navy, what was it called?
It was an AD, but it was
an AD. That means what you did. If you worked around a ship, shipyard, generator,
flight deck.
Oh my gosh, that's the easiest one. And the people, the VA, sometimes doesn't like people like us because we got to educate you and your father or your uncle to say, hey, you were on a flight deck. You deserve hearing aids.
Yeah.
You're 72 years of age now, and you're afraid of your pride. You don't want to go ask. Well, we'll ask for you.
So, reach out. Find out what you need to know.
So how can people contact you to get that information?
They can call the main number of the DAV, which is 636-940-636-7577. Here's a little magic.
We like magic.
Yes, we do. Hold on.
1-800.
Ooh. That's a magic wand, Joel.
Magic wand. Magic. magic. That's just to get somebody's attention, and I'll tell you why.
Time Magazine's 50 yep. sexiest men
he
in the world.
He definitely looks pretty familiar. Who's that?
1-800-827-1000. You know, Ben, if you're in Connecticut, or you're in California, or you're in Nebraska,
Oklahoma,
or you're in Florida, Oklahoma, they'll tell you, what number do I call, sir? 1-800-827-1000. With that number, you can call and identify yourself. They'll find you, and then they'll ask you, what do you want? I want to check on a land deal. I want to check on medical deal. I want to check on my percentage or my history of disability. And you know, some people in that age bracket, you remember I was telling you about, they probably got hurt. And remember, when you're filing a claim, you have to, it's going to be 100% easier if it happened to you in the military service. That's very important. And if it's documented in the military service. And so I must add to my friends out here that the Vietnam era, between 1959 to 1975, May 6th, when the war was over, it was the most undocumented war ever.
Yeah.
You know?
I can see that.
Mm. Thank you. Black and white TV was just coming in. Mm. Radio was just coming in. The camera, for all you that know, the little Instamatic 124. Remember that little bitty camera?
No, I do not.
Now I'm talking to three people. They don't even know what I'm talking about. By the time you sent pictures back home and so forth, it was about 2 or 3 weeks or a month.
Yeah.
So what was our news media? I'm not blaming the news media. It was just behind times back then. So that what happens there, why I mention that, is because when you go file a claim, somebody's going to ask you, well, Eric, you're going to have to tell me, or Jenica, you got to tell me precisely, and don't exaggerate. Because I'm going to tell you the number one enemy that the veterans have in filing a good claim. You were brought up in it, born and raised in it. You were too. It's called the computer.
Yeah, I was going to jokingly say that.
Yeah.
It's a computer because they'll go over there and they'll say, well, when were you in the service, Ben? A great honorable, let's take a Bronze Star veteran. He says, oh, around April of 68. They go down there and check their file, and he was in November of 69. He can't think.
Yeah. Well, who can remember that?
Who can remember that?
I don't remember
that
what I did last week. I can't imagine going,
yes. And so then the poor little old veteran says, around there. And then the computer calls up.
You say, no, it's not there.
Then he goes, where? Yeah. You've heard that, Ben. Get in the back of the line.
Yeah.
Mm. Mm. And they don't mean that, but there's so many that are.
Yeah, they got to keep
chugging. Especially in the great state of Texas.
So get your facts straight.
You
get
bet.
Your discharge papers. Reach out to the DAV if you need help. You deserve it.
Yeah.
We're
running out of time for your segment. What else do you want to get out about this?
Do you know in this vicinity right here, let's say the city of Wichita Falls, is about 12,000 veterans. In this North Texas area, 33,000.
Wow.
That's awesome.
You know, in the 13th congressional district that we are in, you know how many is there? 66,000. And the Secretary of Veterans Affairs that I was with many years ago said, Joel, your job is to put volume, 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 volume on the books so we can help these veterans.
Yeah.
But you got to help yourself. Just like you were in the military. Stand tall, stand proud, salute, and help yourself. And when they ask you a question, answer it. Yes or no? Don't hee-haw around, because that's what's going to get you in trouble.
Right.
So, you know, there's one thing that you hear this ferocious PTSD, mm-hmm. post-traumatic stress disorder.
Yeah.
Well, me and a fellow veteran, Harry Patterson, of course, started this wellness center that's going to be here in Wichita Falls, Texas.
Awesome.
Came out of Angel Fire, New Mexico. Great deal. We've served many families up there of the veterans that need this help on the post-traumatic. It was unheard in our war.
Yeah.
It was unheard.
It wasn't even a term.
You probably know more about it than I do because you're educated in the field.
Mm.
Now we're learning now, so,
yeah.
You know, and I commend these organizations that come together and maybe through my network. And that's what it's about, Jenica. We've touched somebody's heart here today, because if you tell your I'm talking about the kids this tall, 7 years old to 12 years old, 16 years old. Tell them to get your grandfather, your uncle, your aunt, and tell them to get into this system, because it's not charity. It is not charity. And most veterans says, I did my best. I did honorable discharge. I didn't do anything. Yes, you did. You served for this great country, and now you deserve everything that I am going to help you get.
There you go. Here, here.
Well, sir.
Hey. All right, thanks, Joel. All right. Don't go anywhere, Joel, though. We're taking a quick emotional break. We want you to stay right there. We're going to come back, and then we're going to give you one more chance to tell people how to get a hold of you or get a hold of them if they want your help. When we come back, with more of That City Show.
I'm Teresa Rose with the City of Wichita Falls, Deputy Director of Public Works, and I choose to reuse. 66% of your waste can be reused in our compost program. Composting is the best environmental program. It saves on landfill space, reduces air pollution, and is very cost effective. The City of Wichita Falls has one of the state's top composting programs.
I choose to reuse.
I choose to reuse. Participate the Green Cartway by calling 940-761-7977.
This isn't just putting up a dam like they did 100 years ago and saying that's how much it's going to flood. This is designing a lake for the end user, for the people of this community, for the hikers, the bikers, the wildlife viewers, the hunters, the anglers. And what kind of gift can you pass on to the next generation? What is your legacy? How about sitting out here 50 years from now when you're crotchety and old and you're telling your great-grandkids that you helped make this happen?
Support LakeWichita.com.
Breaking in for an important news announcement from the Wichita Falls, Wichita County Public Health District.
It's time to save the fingers. Learn more about diabetes. It starts with prevention, education, self-management. Free classes for individuals at risk for or have type 2 diabetes. Know your numbers and learn how to live a healthier, more active life. Go to doihaveprediabetes.org and take the risk assessment and call 761-7975 to register for classes today.
Welcome back to That City Show. Hey, I'm sorry if you guys fell asleep in that last segment. I know Joel was not very animated, mumbling a little bit, not very much passion.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Joel. We appreciate all that. We're running a little behind. We're going to get right into no song today. Thank you for that.
So sad about that.
Typical What the Choose News, dude.
All right, we got several things coming up. Wrestling Under the Stars is sponsored by the Wichita Falls Wrestling Association. That's going to be kicking off at the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame Induction Week, Friday, May 18th at Big Blue. It's the big giant building downtown. That's Blue. 6:30 to 9:30 p.m. That is happening. So you're going to meet some top indie wrestlers from across the United States. It's going to be really fun. You should definitely check that out.
I believe a wrestler I had a run-in with 8 years ago is going to be wrestling there.
All right. You ready to
more
rematch?
More on that later next week when Johnny Mantel is here.
Okay. That sounds like fun. Cajun Fest is going to be back Saturday, May 12th, downtown Wichita Falls. Eat your heart out. There's going to be gumbo. There's going to be crawfish, jambalaya, etouffee, boudin, and more.
Right,
boudin. I always say that word wrong. There's going to be Cajun and Zydeco music. It's going to be live, so please participate this, and it's a lot of fun. There's a gumbo
Gator
cook-off.
Wrestler's going to be there again.
I hope not. Okay.
You probably don't
wonderful,
like
yeah. yeah. Tickets are $7 in advance, and they're $10 at the gate, and kids 12 under are free.
I'll be flying my drone.
You gotta be cooler about
people.
It, Eric.
Not over people. To the side.
Not over the freeway.
Not over the freeway video we saw.
You can get your tickets now at the downtownwf.com and find a link on Facebook under Cajun Fest 2018. And the last but certainly not least, Live at the Lake is happening again. Cousin Fuzzy is going to be performing Thursday, May 10th at 6:30 in the Pretty Pavilion at the Midwestern Museum of Art.
Yeah.
So that's happening. So you should check that. Those are all fun.
It's the first of the series. You know, they had the fall concert series. Now we're into summer. They do Live at the Lake. I think it's once a month, but it's always going to be at that pavilion
it's
right down the lake.
It's a little amphitheater. You can go Pokemon Go. People still do that. And listen to some awesome music at the same
people
time.
People still do that?
Yeah, people still do that.
As soon as we get that City Show band together, we'll probably
all right, let's do it.
There.
I can play the coconuts.
You're saying.
I'm a mean coconut
play
player.
Play the spoon.
Oh, yeah. No, I can't do that. Things happening in Riverbend real quick. Dallas Zoo is coming May 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. Please come to this.
We're
it's so
go.
Cool. Not many people get the opportunity to go to the zoo, so they're bringing animals to us, and then you'll be educating people about them, like flamingos and tortoises, a tamandua, which is an anteater. They bring a sloth. They bring birds of prey. They bring cool python, like a giant python. So this is open to the public. You do not have to reserve unless you have a group of 10 or more. There's two shows a day. There's one at 10 o'clock and there's one at 11:15.
Last year we went, and I don't say this often, that flamingo was a baller.
Dude, we have a bond. I
never said that before.
Yeah, it was Bahama, and she snuggled me. Seriously. Oh, we had a connection. Oh, anyway, that was warm. But yeah, definitely come check that out. That's going to be happening at May 1st, 2nd, and 3rd at Riverbend Nature Center. Do not miss this. It happens once a year, and we need people to come out and support it. Otherwise, we're not going to be able to do it. So please come, reserve, do it now, riverbendnaturecenter.org.
Yeah. And like I say, the kids get to get right up on those animals.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're going to be like, oh, look, a flamingo. And they're like, oh, my God.
I don't know if I'm comfortable with my kid and a bird of prey or a python.
Oh, shush. She'll be fine. The 11:15 shows aren't as crowded. So if you're worried about school groups, just come to those. Then it'll be a little bit more personal. And plus, if you stay afterwards, you get to kind of meet animals. But that's not guaranteed.
And you can watch Jenica really stressed out.
Oh, it's great. I'm in the parking lot. Anyway, it's fine.
You parked there.
God, they don't listen. Thank you so much, police officers. I love you. You're awesome. They listen to people in uniforms. They don't listen to a screaming girl in an orange vest, even though the orange vest means power. Anyway, also, 9 to 5 is opening April 27th at Backdoor Theater, and we have a surprise in store for you.
Lily Tomlin role.
It's
surprises?
Happening.
Like guest stars?
Mm-hmm.
Joel?
Yeah.
I'll be there. You know why?
Get your tickets now. Come see me in action
so I can
make a fool of myself dancing. It's going
to
be great.
You're going to have to tell us what the surprise is after. I want to know.
Okay, sounds good.
It's Mayor Stephen Santillana, isn't it?
Oh, I hope so.
Rap battle.
God. 80s style. That would be great.
All right, there you go. That was Choose News.
That's it. Put yourself on ChooseWichitaFalls.com. Do it. If you're bored, it's your fault.
Oh, it's your fault. We were going to say that. All right, Joel, one more time. How do people get a hold of y'all if they want to get all their benefits?
940-636-7577. She said a date 27th. Guess what May 28th is? That's the day
after.
That day after. But it's a solemn day that we honor our dead.
Oh, it's Memorial Day.
Memorial Day.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Check with your local service organization, service office downtown, and then at 6:30, at 6 o'clock that morning at Crestview, we put out 3,000 flags. People, the citizens of Wichita Falls, service organizations, American Legion 169 heads that, and so I recommend everybody go out there and feel the honor of placing somebody's flag.
I like that. I had no idea y'all did that.
Thank you
so much, Joel. All right, you guys come on out to that, too. And veterans, get a hold of them. And make sure you take advantage of all the stuff that's offered through the DAV.
Oh, do you know that we got the best transportation program in the state of Texas?
Mm.
We transport veterans 1 to 5 every day to Oklahoma City on a transportation van.
Just contact the DAV.
Yeah,
just do
it. Just contact
Joel. Just
we only
do
have
it.
30 minutes here. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Appreciate y'all.
And on behalf of Joel Jimenez, Jenica Lambert, and Benjamin Rimmer, I am Eric Crossland, and this has been That's a Show! That's a Show!